The afternoon of August 14, 2003 was hot and humid in northern Ohio. At 2:02 p.m., a high-voltage transmission line sagged and made contact with an overgrown tree.
Transmission lines will sag down lower as they get heated up, and they can be heated up by the air temperature as well as the amount of electricity flowing through the wires, which means that they get closer to the ground. Because there's so much electricity flowing through those wires, any tree that comes into contact with that would be devastating.
One tree growing under transmission lines created a domino effect, triggering the largest, most expensive blackout in U.S. history, affecting over 50 million people in 8 states and 2 Canadian provinces. Electric reliability standards were revised after the blackout, requiring all utilities to implement reliability programs that focus on the trimming or removal of trees and vegetation growing in or adjacent to power line rights of way. Rights of way are corridors of land that run underneath high voltage transmission lines. Easement agreements give us permission to maintain trees and vegetation growing in or adjacent to transmission line rights of way.
Typically, that means that we're removing trees and shrubs in the wire zone, removing or trimming trees in the border zone, and then following up with a herbicide, which will then prevent those trees from coming back.
We first began constructing high-voltage transmission lines in northern Illinois nearly 100 years ago. Today, we maintain thousands of miles of transmission lines that deliver electricity throughout the Midwest. Electricity flows along transmission lines from power plants to substations, where transformers step down voltages for distribution to homes and businesses. Transmission lines are inspected annually, and vegetation is maintained on a 5-year cycle.
We have to maintain an air gap. There has to be a specific amount of distance between anything and that transmission line, or there could be a flashover. So it doesn't actually have to touch. The electricity voltage can actually jump to something that's close to the wires.
We have also partnered with several local organizations to help reestablish native plants that don't interfere with transmission lines. These plants provide environmental benefits, such as increased plant and wildlife diversity, a pollinator habitat for bees and butterflies, and reduced carbon dioxide.
What's really interesting about our transmission right-of-ways is that they can be green corridors. They can travel through from community to community. They don't stop at village borders. So when we can work with some of these groups to establish native plantings and compatible plantings throughout our transmission right-of-ways, they can really be part of the green infrastructure of our communities.
To help ensure safe, reliable power, trees, shrubs, or climbing plants should never be planted on or near transmission rights of way. Contact between vegetation and a high voltage transmission line could cause a widespread power outage that affects millions of customers. ComEd is here to help, so please contact us at 1-800-EDISON-1 and ask to speak with a vegetation management team member if you have any questions about tree maintenance near high-voltage transmission lines. Visit ComEd.com/trees for more information on the company's vegetation management program. ComEd, powering lives.